Adrian, thanks for clicking on to this late edition of the Europe and the UK and Europe video blog for today. We're now on the 26th of October, and we continue to see a very, very active pattern across Europe at the moment. We seem to be in a pattern at the moment that was forecasted away back nearly 3 months ago now for a very active jet stream. The storm train in off the Atlantic would be very active. The pulses, the areas of low pressure would continue to bombard the UK as well as many parts of Europe as well. And that appears to be the case for sure. Over the past, of course, several days, we've seen tremendous amounts of flooding, particularly so across the eastern part of the Republic of Ireland. We've seen, of course, Dublin city centre, a large part of it underwater. And of course, as well as that, we've seen Devon, Cornwall up into Pembrokeshire as well, with pretty significant flooding as well. And we've seen the leading front, the main frontal system, that actually all part of the same front that was producing the tremendous rains up across Ireland and the UK, was actually all associated all the way down through Spain as well. And it produced some tremendous amounts of rainfall across Spain through southern France, and it produced snow as well up across the Alpine regions as well, through Switzerland and Austria, probably even the French Alps and the Italian Alps. We've seen a tremendous amount of flooding across, particularly some of the coastal resorts in northern Italy, where as much I've seen one report of as much as 20 inches of rain fell in just a few hours. The problem is with the fronts that get that far south, they actually jack up, they become more powerful as they ingest warmer air that's available down there that isn't actually available up here at this latitude. But certainly down once that front tapped into warmth off the Mediterranean. Of course, the waters around the Mediterranean are still very, very warm. We're just on the heels of excuse me, what has been a pretty warm summer down there. And so the environment is much more juicy, much more volatile, so to speak. So you drive a very strong, active, powerful jet into that region, a cold front, and you've got some terrific amounts of rainfall that can be produced. And we've seen that twice of actually over just the course of a couple of weeks through Spain as well as Italy. Of course, it's not only a week or so ago that Rome was underwater as well. So it's that type of pattern, folks. It was a pattern that I've been very, very concerned about throughout the summer months, and I believe it's materializing exactly the way I thought it would. And unfortunately, folks, at the moment, I don't see any change taking place in this pattern. I think we're going to see more tremendous amounts of rainfall. Wind, rain is going to be the dominant factor, milder conditions as well. What you will notice, though, is as we progress through the month of November, once these frontal systems pass through, they produce tremendous amounts of rain, we are going to see more floods, unfortunately. I think there's going to be several instances over the next 4 to 6 weeks where we're going to see some of those fronts produce tremendous amounts of rain. Why are we seeing so much rain? The problem is, if you look at that cloud band that went basically due north up through the Irish Sea, producing amazing amounts of rainfall in Dublin and the east coast of the Republic. We've also seen, of course, the tremendous amounts of rain through the southwest of England, South Wales as well. That moisture and that corridor, that plume of moisture, was all getting fed all the way up from the subtropics, from the Azores, from Spain. All that air was getting forced up along that cold front, and that is the reason why we're seeing such tremendous amounts of rain. The warmer conditions down across the southern part of Europe is going to feed these cold fronts as they sweep eastwards across the UK. So you've been warned, we're going to be seeing more floods, unfortunately, folks. I do believe that. And unfortunately as well, as we progress into the colder times ahead, these areas of low pressure are going to deepen, become more stronger. So therefore, I'm worried more about stronger wind events as well as the rainfall that accompany it. Very wild pattern is unfolding. It is already materializing, and I think it'll continue to do so over the next 4 to 6 weeks. So watch out on the tail end of some of them low pressures as well as the front pass through. The wind field then pulls that air from the north. The air, of course, is getting colder across the north, so don't be surprised if we start to see cooler air getting driven in by the tail end of these low pressure systems off the Atlantic. Are we going to see snow? Raising the chance now to 20%, perhaps 30%, particularly across northern sections of the UK as we progress into the latter part of November. Not the early part, the latter part of November. I think we might see the first slight chances of snowfall for some of the towns and cities across Scotland, perhaps the north of England as well. But the continued bombardment of fronts driving through Europe at the moment will continue. We're going to see very unsettled conditions across the vast majority of the continent, actually, and it will remain fairly mild, cooler across Scandinavia and places like that, not unusual, as well as across the eastern part of Europe through the Ukraine and Russia as well. We're seeing cooler air getting fed down in a trough over in the far eastern part of the continent. But that Atlantic jet stream, folks, is active. It's going to continue to produce strong areas of low pressure, heavy rain, and in between those areas of lows, we might see calmer conditions like we're seeing tonight and we've seen last night. Temperatures are going to start to drop off as the nights are quite lengthy now at this time of year. So don't be surprised to see in between this active jet stream and low pressure train, don't be surprised to see some frost. You'll be scraping your car. You'll need to bundle up some mornings. But it's the cold air itself is all bottled up to the north, and we'll continue to see that charge up for the next several weeks before we do see winter eventually. We will see winter eventually, folks, and it might come as a big punch later in the month of December. So thanks for watching. Hope you're staying warm, safe wherever you are today, and stay tuned to the blog. Bye for now.